right, man, I'm ready. NBA 2K18 is right down the corner. We're getting so much information now about the different archetypes and the thousands, hundreds of blends that you can make. And so I've been sifting through all of them, trying to make the decision on which archetype I'm gonna choose. I tweeted out, I decided. I'm sure now which archetype I'm gonna be making first and which archetype I'm gonna be making second. Now this video right here is if you're trying to make the best possible build. We're not talking about having fun. When it comes to having fun, I do my sharpshooter thing, but I'm also gonna have a pure slasher. So I'm gonna lay out the information. I'm not gonna make the decision for you. I'm gonna let you decide because I know for a fact this archetype I'm looking at right now looks ridiculous. And based on some factors that we don't know yet, if it comes to fruition, I'm gonna be destroying the game day one. Now let's lay out the facts. One thing we know is Mike Wang said that attributes matter this year. The number we heard was if you have a 60 open shot three, you're making 25% on wide open 3-point shots. That means for me that if you have a 60 or under, forget about it. I'm sagging all the way down in the paint, helping getting ready to rotate. So for me, that's not an archetype that I'm willing to play with. I want to stretch the floor so much that I'm creating millions of opportunities for my teammates to get open. Also keep in mind, we don't know the different heights this year from which we can speed boost. We know speed boosting is in the game, but we don't know what its new limits are. Last year, it was a 6'2 if you were on Sunset. Now it's also more important to note that their stamina depletes faster this year. And so you're not going to be sitting there ISO dribbling all clock holding the R2 button. Unless you can find dribble moves that don't use turbo, you're not gonna be dribbling too much before you have to take it to the tin or pass it to your teammate. All right, knowing all of that, I know I'm gonna be a shooter. That's me, right? So off rip, you guys should know I'm gonna make a pure archetype. Now I've been watching some videos of people giving advice on whether you should go pure or go blend. From so far, every time I talk to the devs, they're like, you can do blend, but you pure, because pure archetypes have more Hall of Fame badges. It looks like so many people are putting the emphasis on badges. Now this is a time for you to make a bet. Just like last year at the launch of 2K17, I made a bet between playmakers and sharpshooters. I went with sharpshooters. It was the best build the entire year round. This year, I'm also making a bet, and I'm gonna share that decision with the world so that you can make a similar, if not different, decision. You gotta decide what you value more right now, attributes or badges. No, not necessarily what you value more, but what you think 2K is gonna value more. And right now, based on the info we know, I'm going with attributes. So that means that my main archetype is gonna be a blend and not a pure sharpshooter. In fact, it's not even gonna be a primary sharpshooter. Now take a look at this screenshot here. This is the first blend I will be using. The first archetype is likely gonna be my main. I'm gonna be using NBA 2K18. Now there's some changes. Some archetypes have different badges this year. Some archetypes have different specialties. So to break it down for you, the shot creators and the sharpshooters look like a deadly combo. So it's gonna be called a shot creating sharpshooter is gonna be the real name for the archetype. The best mid-range shooters in the game are gonna be shot creators. On top of that, this year, mid-range Deadeye is no longer a Hall of Fame for sharpshooters. Now we get gold tireless scorer instead. It's also important to note, for some reason, sharpshooters and shot creators have an unbelievably high amount of stamina. That being said, compared to last year, sharpshooters have way less speed. So the player I play with when I was at the event is part of the reason why I'm making this specific build, was a sharpshooting shot creator. Now he was 84 overall, he was 6'5", and he was slow. He played like a 6'8" sharpshooter in terms of speed when it came to, I was like, I can't do this, man. It's too slow, I'm not gonna get myself open, unless of course there's a speed boost that we haven't learned yet. The reason shot creator first makes so much sense is because it gives you a massive boost to the dribbling attributes. It knocks down your three-pointer some because now you're no longer a primary three-point shooter. But you have Hall of Fame tireless scorer, Hall of Fame difficult shots with a good three-point shot. You now have Hall of Fame difficult shots. And you have Hall of Fame mid-range Deadeye, and you have the max mid-range. Now, here's the one question mark about the build, and this is what I was saying, it depends on some factors. We don't know more than what we see on the screen right now. If limitless range is gold on this archetype, match set, this can be the most popular archetype in the game. Actually, I think the most popular is gonna be a playmaking primary, a sharpshooting secondary. I don't think that's gonna be the best archetype in the game. I think it's gonna be the most popular just because people are doing it based off what they've played in 2K17. They're thinking, if I can playmake and shoot the three ball, but they're not taking into account all the changes, all the info that's been dropping so far in the last few months. Now, ankle breaker is a useless badge this year. You're not getting, I was playing for an hour maybe on the park, I didn't get one ankle breaker. I saw one person get an ankle breaker, and it was Kyrie, and it was in a 5-on-5 game. I'm assuming Kyrie has Hall of Fame ankle breaker. So that's not a badge I'm worried about. Teardropper, useless. In fact, most of the playmaker badges outside of Hall of Fame Dimer, I'm not even worried about. But just that combo of having the gold sharpshooter badges with now Hall of Fame difficult shots, Hall of Fame tireless scorer, and I'm gonna make him a shorter player, around 6'2". I'm gonna make him minimum weight so he's faster, and I think I'm gonna make him max wingspan, but I don't know. We're gonna have to do research on the wingspan shit to find out. Is he's gonna be a fast, likely, and hopefully a speed boosting shot creator that could also shoot with so many fucking badges from 3-point land. The only negative to this specific archetype is that I can't shoot from agent range anymore. Like, agent range, you're gonna need Hall of Fame limitless. You know, you're not gonna be able to pull up with goal limitless and do the same thing. Which is why I'm also gonna be making a pure sharpshooter. I'm gonna be using both of these. Now, the pure sharpshooter I make is likely gonna be 6'5 or 6'6. All my players are gonna be left-handed. All of them gonna be rocking either number 0 or 23. I know that. The only way this doesn't become the best possible archetype at the end of the day is if the 3-point right there increased for moving shots, not for standing shots. So if you get what I'm saying, is that your standing shot isn't gonna be that good, but your moving shots can be crazy. So really it all depends on that. Jeez, that means this year you can take ankles and then go up for a 3 from limitless. That's crazy. But if you are a 3-point shooter, and keep in mind, if you're a 3-point shooter that likes to spot up in the corner, this is easily not gonna be the build for you. But if you wanna be a point guard, run the point, and create your shots and shoot deadly from 3-point, then this might be it. This is it. This is the one. The thing I like about the shot creator is it takes the sharpshooter, you get a minus on 3-pointer a little bit, but you get a boost on ball handling, you get a boost on athleticism, and those are the things that, especially when you're trying to create your own shots, you're gonna need. You mesh those two things together, the only L you're taking is not having Hall of Fame limitless range, and the rest is straight W. In fact, if you're playing with me in NBA 2K18 and you can't shoot the 3-ball, turn your PS4 off. I'm not gonna be on your team. It's just that simple, because I'm the last thing I want is somebody doubling up on me because you can't shoot the 3-ball. There's a lot of players I see making lockdowns pure, or driving and finishing pure. And I'm like, that's fine, because those builds are gonna be fun and I'm gonna wanna play with those builds myself. But I'm not gonna be on a team with a guy who can't shoot and stretch the floor, especially in 2K when it's so simple to close out. And by the way, this year, you can't just hold L2 to do all the defense for you. You have to close out and do all that stuff for yourself manually. But I'm saying, it's so simple to close out that if you can't shoot the 3-ball, is you're making everybody on the team's life harder. The only time that makes sense for me is if you're like a pure paint protector. And then I could see why, all right? Because if you're protecting the paint for us on the defensive end, I understand. But I'm gonna be playing a little bit different than most of y'all. When I play NBA 2K, or even when I'm playing in real life, I'm like Mike D'Antoni. Why don't we stop worrying about defense? We're just gonna outscore the other team. Because as much as I'd like to believe that defense wins championships, NBA 2K is such an offensive-oriented game. If you're not firing on all cylinders, then you're missing out. Now, I tend to believe that the post scorer is gonna be a really good build this year. I think the pure playmaker might be holding an L this year, because if they can't shoot the 3-ball like they did last year, and they can't, what's gonna happen, man? If you can't do all the dribble moves to shoot a 3, if people predict that you're gonna go to the paint every time, I'm just saying, that might be a little bit more simple to, unless you have some crazy dribble moves, it's gonna be a lot easier to clamp down on the playmakers now that you can sag off a little bit. So anyway, that's it for the video, all right? This is the build when it comes to attributes. All the way. I'm saying, you gotta make a decision whether it's badges or attributes. If you're going for badges, you have to make a pure player. So, in my opinion, I recommend a pure sharpshooter. But if you're going for attributes, without a doubt, I haven't seen an attribute, nor will I, that's even close to competing with what this one can offer. So we'll see, man. I'm gonna dig through more of these and see if I can uncover anything else, man. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to drop a like. Let me know what y'all think about the archetype and which one are you rocking with, because you don't necessarily have to use what I use. It's just the play style that I prefer. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video. If you guys are new, be sure to subscribe. I'm out. Peace.